Welcome everyone, in this tutorial we will cover how you can make the player spin when pressing shift or any other button that you like. In our example we will use a third person character blueprint, but you can use any character blueprint that you want as long as it uses the character movement component. We will start off with setting up the input mappings. You can find this in the project settings and search for input. There you can add an action map called sprint, and we will bind it to the left and right shift key, but you can bind it to whatever key you like. If you want to learn more about the input mappings of Unreal Engine and how they work, let me know and I will make another video about it. Now that we have the input mappings, it's time to open up our character blueprint and make two new variables, a walk speed and a sprint speed. Both are floats. We will also make two functions, a start sprint and a stop sprint. In the start sprint function, we will set the max speed of our character movement to the sprint speed, and in the stop sprint, we will put it back to our walking speed. Don't forget to set the sprint speed to whichever value you like. In our example, we will take 20,000 to really see the difference, but I recommend putting it way lower than that. I've also put the variable to public so that our imaginary designers can change it if they want to. For the walking speed, we will just set it in our begin play and query the value from the character movement component. All that is left to do is to call our start sprint when the player presses shift and stop sprint when the player releases shift. Now you should have a working sprint, like this. You might wonder why we bothered putting this in separate events in the first place and not just hooking it straight up into the input action event like this. If, for example, we had other code that needed to run when start or stopping the sprint, like a sound effect for example, it can easily be added without sacrificing any readability. But also because we might want to call the stop sprint function before the player releases the button. For example, when they run out of stamina, or start shooting, or in our example, whenever they start jumping like this. Here you can see the player running, jumping, and after the jump, they stop sprinting. Thanks for watching, and see you guys next week.